The Bearsons Movie on the big screen. Our story begins in a bear cave for where the Bearsons used to live there, for when only Bort, however, was born as a raccoon, which was most unusual for Andy and Barbara to be having a raccoon in a house. And then, by the time next few years, Barbara was pregnant again. She had another baby, and it was another surprise. It was Ben Bearson. Yeah, because it was another baby's name, just to let you know. Because Ben, however, is very special. Because he's gifted, and plus, he says a few words at an early age. And then, when Andy and his family thinks that the bear cave is getting a bit too small, they have decided that they would probably move to England so that they could live somewhere. Oh, and of course, however, as for Lisa, however, well, it was an ordinary day for Lisa, for when Lisa and her family are arguing about her newfound vegetarianism, and Bart wasn't even fed up. And Lisa, however, is getting angry at her father, and same with Homer too. And then she's had enough of her father because she called him a prehistoric carnivore, and then she's out of here, and then she has to move to the UK to find a local boyfriend. And indeed she did. She found the right place. Yeovil, the heart of a country, the mind of a city. especially when she tries to find a perfect home for herself. This is the green room for where Andy and Barbara go there to have a little coffee and have a cake to go with it, because Andy needs to calm down after Bort's antics with his bad behaviour. And speaking of Bort, this is the place for where Bort has been with his family over here over the years when he was a kid. It was Blockbuster Video, in which he used to rent out some good videos like He-Man, Alf, and yes, even The Simpsons when it first came out in 1990. And wow, it was very good. And there's the best place for where Ben and Lisa usually likes to do during the day, which is the Yeofield Library, in which Lisa teaches Ben on how the world works. And Ben, however, loves Lisa's learning because he knew that if he wants to be smart like Lisa, he'd have to go to the library with her, which is romantic, well, for some nerds. Here's the most famous nightclub in all of Yeofield, which is Club Neo, in which when Ben and Lisa likes to do a spot of dancing. And then, of course, they get to listen to a saxophone player. Well, of course, it's not Lenny Guns Murphy anyway. Well, it's probably another saxophone player, which I don't know the name of. Well, you probably get the picture anyway. Oh, yes, I also forgot to mention that Lisa had to bring Maggie with her too, so that she can take her to a day nursery in Smarties at Yeovil. That's where Maggie goes, as she likes to have some fun, and it's much better than an Iron Rand school for tots. Yeah, you probably know that by now. Now, you probably remember the reprise clip from the beginning in the film. Do you know? Well, do you? No. I don't want to see that again. Anyways, let's get back to the film. Here's Ben Bearson sleeping. And I think that he's sleeping with his little darling, Lisa Simpson. And here she is now. Ah, and I see there's Ben Bearson dreaming about something. I wonder what he's dreaming about.
Oh, Lisa, I could kiss you. Oh, you're so pretty.
Huh? Where on earth is that sound coming from? Oh, I better listen. Yep, must be coming from a certain girl that I know of. Well, I'm gonna have a crawl over here. Right, now where is... Lisa? heck. Oh, whoa! Yes, my darling? Give me a smooch. Alright then, I'll give you a smooch.
Oh, what's wrong?
Oh no! It's happening right now!
Into a grizzly bear! Look!
Huh? What's all this screaming going on? Oh, hello there!
Oh, I'm Andy Bearson. Oh, and I also heard that we are in a movie. Wahey! Oh, and I also heard that Ben screamed. Oh, I better go and have a check with him to see if he's all right. Ben? Are you okay, son? Ben? Speak to me, pal. I'm your father. Tell me. Oh, dear. Well, I guess he's gone into shock mode. Dieters? Yes? Do you have anything that could smell Ben right up to his nose?
Well, I do have some Pepsi-Packs, Ken. Do you want to get it?
Yes, please. Can you get it for me?
Oh, yeah, sure thing, Andy. There you go, Andy.
Right, thank you. Right. All right, Ben. Right, I'm just going to put this can right under your nose so that you can have a sniff. Come on, Ben. Take a sniff. Are you alright, son?
Oh, I'm alright, Dad. Sorry if I screamed. I've just had a bit of a nightmare, that's all.
Nightmare? What's your nightmare, Ben?
Ah, well, you see, Dad, when I was just skipping around with Lisa, and I didn't realise that she had a flower on her head, and then, but by the time that when I started to kiss Lisa, I dreamt that I was turned into a big grizzly bear. So that the grizzly bear thinks that I'll be mauling Lisa.
Oh! So that's your nightmare?
Yeah, that's right, Dad. Yeah, because, I was a bit worried that I might turn into a grizzly bear. Like Grizzly was.
Oh, don't you worry, son. Well, me, Mom, and you, well, we may be turned into the Three Bears, but we certainly are not grizzly bears.
Ah, well, that's good to hear, Dad. What about Bort, however? Is Bort going to be a grizzly bear too?
No, son. I don't think Bort's a grizzly bear. He's a raccoon.
Oh, yeah.
So, Dad, so what do some grizzly bears do? Well, grizzly bears, son. Well, grizzly bears, it's like a big type of bear that some bears do growl, and they were only trying to scare humans away, which we don't, not with Lisa and Maggie around. I'm sure that both of them are fine.
Oh, so let me get this straight, Dad. So what you're saying is that the grizzly bear is a big type of bear because then they can growl at enemies as they walk by.
Yeah, that's right, son. Because grizzly bears are big and dangerous animals.
And whenever you did try to make a growling voice, well, that doesn't scare them away.
And no, Ben, I know you're not a grizzly bear. I promise you, Dad, you're not a grizzly bear.
Ah, thanks, Dad. Oh, and I'm sorry if I screamed.
That's okay, son. I understand. Right. Why don't you go back into the bed now, okay?
Well, okay, Dad. And thank you very much.
You're welcome. Well, see you in the morning, everybody.
Well, and I suppose I better get back to bed.
Alright, everybody. Don't worry about me. I'm in bed now. Yeah, sorry if I screamed.
Oh, Lisa, did you have a nice sleep?
Yeah, I've had a nice sleep, Benny. Oh, well, the pop of the noise that you're making. So, what were you screaming?
Well, you see, Lisa, I dreamt that I was a grizzly bear at the end.
Oh, yeah. You screamed. Oh, it's okay, Penny. I think I'll cuddle you instead. How does that sound?
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea, Lisa. Yeah, I think we'll just snuggle.
Yeah, because you know how much I love snuggling.
Yeah, I miss you, Penny. Oh, well, see you in the morning, everybody.
Yeah, see you in the morning, everybody.
The next day.
Hey, guys, it's breakfast time.
Breakfast time?
Ooh, I wonder what we're having for breakfast. Right, come on then, my lovely. Let's go downstairs and get some breakfast.
Oh, okay, Penny. And good morning.
Yeah, good morning, sweetie. Right, let's go downstairs and get some breakfast.
Okay, Penny. See you downstairs, everybody.
And see you later, everybody, for when we have some breakfast. Right, well, we're coming now, Dad. Right, come on, boy. Yeah, time for breakfast. Oh, all right, bit, little bro. Right, I'm coming.
Ooh, breakfast time. Ooh, I wonder what we're happy for breakfast today. Could it be this for breakfast? Eat.
What?
Yes, Dad?
Come downstairs and get some breakfast.
All right. See you in a minute, everybody.
After breakfast.
All right, everybody. Well, I don't know about you, but I've already had some breakfast now.
And it's a good thing that I'm going to play a prank on my dad.
Oh, yeah, by using this can. Oh, but I'm going to give it a good shake. That's better. Now, I know to give it to my dad.
Well, everybody. I don't know about you. I'm very thirsty. Oh, I could do with a cool drink right now. Hey, Dad. Oh, what is it, boy?
I got you a can of Pepsi Max for you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, of course I have, Dad.
Here you are. Ah, thank you, Bort. Ooh, you're so kind.
Yeah, thanks, Dad. Well, I shall leave you to
it. Well, I guess so. I'm going to give him a paper.
Well, see you in a minute, everybody.
I'm going to enjoy watching you. Me.
Alright then. Yum, 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 yum. I love a good bit of Pepsi Max. Right, let's open it. Stop! Oh! Who shook the can? Could it be a sudden person, son? Digest, whoever shook the can.
I'm afraid it was Bort.
Bort?
Oh. Oh, hello, Dad.
Ooh, well, Dad, looks like you're covered in Pepsi Max.
Bort! Oh, take the shock truck can over to the bathroom, please, and get rid of it to recycle.
All right, Dad. I will probably get rid of it. Yeah, but at least I've had some fun with it. But now, I'm going to take this to the bathroom. Well, see you in a minute, everybody. Must I get this can washed?
What does Bort have to play prank on me for? Oh!
Well, I might as well just have a rest now. Alright, everybody. Now, I'm in the bathroom now. Oh, and my dad just told me I'm just to get rid of this. Right, and to pull that over here. Right, after the remaining bit's gone.
And now to fill this can up with water. Oh, and I'm going to give it a shake.
Well, I better put that down first. Dorothy, can you help me fill this can up?
Oh, with pleasure, of course.
Okay. Right, there you go, son. There you go, Bort.
Ah, thank you.
And well done. Now, I reckon that this can might explode.
Right, I'm going to put that in the sink. Ah! Yeah, all sorted and ready to be sorted later. Well, I'm going to get back to the bedroom. See you later, everybody. Huh? How about that? Sounds like there's a Pepsi Max can taking away. I don't think cans normally...
Uh-oh. I think I know.
It might be an explosion! Ah!
What was caused that explosion. Oh, hang on a minute. Could that be something to do with this house?
Oh no, I think I know now. I'm afraid the building will collapse in a minute. In case we're going to have to go to shelter.
Family, pay attention now. Now, I know this sounds crazy, but the building's going to collapse.
Oh no, Andy. Oh, what are we going to do, Andy? We can get out of here and try to shelter.
Barbara, get off me. Get off me. Don't panic, Barbara. Don't panic. Barbara, get off. Oi. Barbara, get off of my face. Right, don't worry, Barbara. Don't panic. We'll get out of here.
Oh, Andy, I'm scared.
Me too, Barbara. Let's get out of here.
Okay, Andy. See you outside, everybody.
Yeah, see you outside. Come on, you three. Let's get out of here. Oh, all right, Dad. Oh, what's going on? The building's going to collapse, Ben. Uh-oh. You two, I'm afraid we're going to have to get out.
Oh dear, oh, I'm scared, Benny.
Right, don't worry, girls. I've got you now. You're safe. Right, I'll carry you all the way to the shelter. Well, see you outside, everybody. Now, don't panic, ladies. I got you now.
Right, well, I suppose that Bort will have to get out himself. Well, hopefully they'll see you outside. Oh, yeah, and I suppose I should be outside too.
Right, everybody, right, in here. Right, okay. Right, wait here, you two, whilst I go and get your mum.
Okay, Dad.
Okay.
Alright, Dad.
Alright, Barbara, where are you?
I'm in here, Andy.
Oh, there you are, Barbara. Right, let's get you in there. There you go, Barbara.
Thank you.
Now to lock up the door. Right. Okay, everybody. Don't worry. We're safe in here now. Oh, and Ben, don't worry about Lisa and Maggie. They're coming to join us.
Oh, okay, Dad. Oh, I can't believe that we have to be in here for shelter. I wonder what could have caused all this to happen.
All right then, family. Now, don't worry. Now, because we all had to be in here, because this is our shelter. Yeah, just until we find out whoever caused our house to explode.
Oh, okay, Andy. Oh, Andy, your house is destroyed.
I know. And I don't think it was usually me that does it. And I wonder who could have done such a thing like that. Well, don't look at me, Dad. I didn't do anything. All I only did was just to be with Lisa and Maggie for a bit. Yeah, you know what my Simpsons sisters are like. Oh, yeah, good thing they are very sensible. And it's not you, is it, Barbara?
No, Andy, and I know it wasn't you.
Ah, well, I believe there is one suspect that could have caused our house to explode. Oh, but don't worry, though. Now, she did that rat were in the shelter, and it's like going back to our bear cave when Bort and Ben was born.
Yeah, but except this is our big cave.
Oh, I see. But plus, Barbara, we also got some food in our fridge, because this is our own fridge.
Oh, that is very good. Good thing you come prepared, Andy.
Yeah, I know, Barbara. That's why we are calling this our shelter. Well, it's just until we find out whoever caused our house to explode just because of some sudden prank.
Okay, Andy. Oh, the board?
Yes, Mum?
Does this have to do with your pranks?
No.
Board, tell me the truth. Otherwise, you'll be thrown out.
Well, you better not throw me out, Mum. Yeah, because I'm sorry I'm not getting a blame for it.
Andy, I don't think Bort's telling the truth, because I think I found out who caused the house to explode. It was Bort Bearson.
What?
What?
Let me get this straight, Barbara. So, who caused our house to explode anyway?
I'm afraid it was Bort, just because of a simple prank, but that's gone wrong.
Bort Bearson? Yes, Dad?
What did you set our house to explode for? I mean, you know you're supposed to do that.
All right, Dad. Let me explain. Look, I'm sorry that we all got end up in a big mess. Well, I know it's a bit of a problem. I know, Dad. I can fix it, Dad. I promise you.
You can fix it. You can fix it! What are you thinking, boy? This is serious!
What did we ever do to you? What did me and your mum did to you? You know you've always causing pranks too much. And this time, you just made the pranks go too far. And now look at that. We're homeless, and we got no food.
Except we got some in the fridge. Oh. Oh, I see.
And also, we're going to starve out here, and all we got to do is to forage some food for winter. You don't know what it's like that to happen, boy. It's because you don't listen to me. Why did you not listen to me in the first place, Bort?
I don't know.
Bort!
Oh, okay then. I admit, it was me that set the house to explode. But I didn't realise that the cap that I've got is when I shake it too hard, and then I have to put it in this thing. That's what's causing it to explode. And I have no idea how that happened.
Well, that is no blooming excuse, boy. When will you ever change your behaviour? I can't trust you anymore if you're going to continue.
Well, I suppose we'll have to find a solution, though. Yeah, I suppose so, Dad. I think that was all my fault, Dad.
Yes, to that point it is your own fault!
Excuse me, Anisha, but you could be with, Ben for a bit. Oh, and help yourself to some food, guys. Okay, Dad.
Okay.
Right, come on, girls. Let's go and get some food for us.
Okay, Benny. See you in a minute, everybody. Gaga. I'm bored. Maggie's not speaking to you anymore.
Ah, how?
Hey. Oh. Well, I suppose that's all my fault then. Oh, great. Oh, God. No, Maggie to be with me.
Yeah, that's right, Bort. Because Maggie doesn't trust you either. So me and Maggie are for shame.
Well, fine. Oh, do you know what, Dad? Can Dad just help us up?
Oh, yeah, sure. Dad, can you help him?
Oh, yeah, sure thing. I'll look for Bort right away. Right, all right, Daddy. Right, Bort's back. Oh, and here he is.
Ah, well, thank goodness for that. All right. Oh, and at least everyone's looking at Bort angrily, which I should join in.
Well, Bort, what do you have to say to everyone? What? Apologize. This is stunt.
Okay, all right. I'm sorry, everyone, for causing our house to explode. And I only thought it was a simple prank just to get back up my dad.
What? You shouldn't have done that in the first place, boy. And now we're homeless.
I don't think...
Bort!
Alright, I guess we are homeless.
Oh, do you know what, Dad?
What?
Oh, I've had enough of you, Dad. You've always treated me like a child.
And you always treat me like a very bad father. Oh. So all you're going to do, Bort, is to count us as stupid things you've done today. And you're going to blame that to Maggie as well?
No, Dad, I'm not blaming it on Maggie.
Well, how come you're not, boy?
Because you've always treated me like a very bad criminal. Do you know what, Dad? I've had enough of you, and in fact, I've had enough of all of you. Because I'm going outside for a walk, and I'm not coming back. Goodbye, Andy.
How?
Well, bad boy, too, Dad.
Bort!
No! I'm sorry! I'm not! Please, Bort! Don't walk out the door! No! Bort!
Don't go out there!
It's not safe out there! You'll get arrested by the police! Bort! My son! What's the penny?
opposite, my sweetheart.
Do you think Bort is upset?
I'm afraid he's way beyond that this time, Lisa. I'm afraid that Bort is now in very big trouble, and he's in very serious trouble. And when I say serious trouble, and I meant serious trouble.
Oh, what's Bort gonna do to himself now? I mean, this is all my fault.
What? Why is it your fault, my darling?
I mean, if I hadn't kept calling him a bawdy boy all the time, this wouldn't have happened. I'm a bad girl.
Oh, it's all right, Lisa, honey. It's all right. There's no need to cry. It's not your fault. And I know you'd like to play pranks on Bort. I understand. Shh. Don't you worry, Lisa, my sweetie pie. I'm sure that our dad will probably have to say sorry to Bort any time of the week.
I hope so, honey. Without our Bort, he's probably gone.
Don't you worry. Well, I'm sure that we're not going to let that happen to Bort. I mean, if he did end up in prison, then I guess me and Bort are through as brothers.
You think so, Ben? Well, this is my fault.
No, don't you worry, sweetie. I don't want you to say that. It isn't your fault. Oh, and no, it wasn't my dad's fault. Was it, Dad? No, son, of course.
Yes, actually, Ben, to be honest, my son, it's all my fault.
Oh, no. First, Lisa thinks it was her fault, and now my dad. All right, then, Lisa. Right, I'm just going to have to put you down for a minute.
Okay, Ben.
Are you all right, Dad? Do you want me to help you up? Yes, please, son. All right, I'll help you. Oh, right, son. Ow! Well, then, Ben, it looks like that Bort has really let this family down this time. Well, he's going to end up in prison for sure.
Oh, and I think this is all my fault.
What? Why is it your fault, Dad?
Well, son, I mean, if I hadn't treated Bort like a child, just like he said, I would have never been a very good father. I'm such a very bad dad.
Oh, come on, Dad. You're not a bad dad to me. No, of course you're not. You're a good father to me. You've helped me. And I also have learned on how to pay my own diapers. You gave me a very special piece of advice on my wedding day to Lisa.
Yeah, that's right. But after what happened to Bort, I don't think I'll ever see him again. I know what your mum.
Well, don't you worry, Dad. I think that we'll all have to sit in a group, and if Bort does come back, he'll probably think that he's made a mistake.
Oh, but what if he's ended up in prison? I mean, and I'll probably go to prison too.
Nah, don't you worry, Dad. We're not going to let him happen. Are we, Mum? Mum, are you okay?
Well, I'm not okay. I mean, was it my fault that Bort has run away from our family? It's anybody's fault.
Don't you worry, Mum. I'll help you up, just like I did with my dad. There you are, Mum.
Thanks, sweetie.
You're welcome, Mum. Oh, are you alright, Maggie? Yeah, right, it's alright. I'll help you. Right, come on, then. Right, there you go, Maggie. Alright, Maggie, I'll just have a little chat with you. Oh, and as for you, Dad, go be with my mum over there.
Oh, okay.
Well, Andy, well, what do we do now?
Well, I don't know, Barbara. Well, I think the only resort is that I'll have to join Bort in prison.
But, Andy, I don't want you to go.
Well, it is Bort's fault, Barbara, for causing the prank in the first place. I just don't know what we're going to do without Bort. I mean, he really let us down this time.
Yeah, I guess so, Andy. Oh, I feel sorry for Bort. Well, Abby, can you do this one right now?
No, I really am a very bad father, Barbara.
You're not a bad father, Abby. You're a good husband to me. I mean, we'll still get our boy back.
Well, if you think so, Barbara. I mean, I know he'll just treat me like a dirty old man would.
No, he wouldn't, Abby. Promise you.
Okay.
Ben.
Yes, Maggie?
Is it Maggie's fault for telling Bort to go away?
Well, I'm afraid it was all our fault, Maggie. But don't worry, it's not really your fault. You only just had to tell her that you were not speaking to him. It's not your fault. I mean, you're a good baby, really. You're a very good friend to Bort. How about a hug?
Okay, Peppa.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I suppose I'll just give you one too. Ah. Well, Maggie, don't you worry about Bort. Well, I'm sure he'll be all right. I mean, after all, what's the point of having Bort round him if it's only just like me, Dad, and Mum are the three bears? Yeah, don't worry, Maggie. We'll get Bort back. I promise you. Yeah, come on. I promise. Well, I sure hope Bort will be alright. I mean, if he's not, and I wonder what's going to happen to him. Well, I'm sure we'll have to find out. Right, don't worry, Maggie. You can sit next to me. Well then, Dad. So, I think we're all together without Bort. Okay. Well then, Bort. You really let us down this time now. Oh, is that the... Oh no, something told me that I shouldn't have run away from home.
It's the police! Oh my goodness! Put up your hands!
That is not good.
Right, you're coming down to the police station, young man. Yeah, because you shouldn't have run away from your parents like that. So, let's handcuff you.
Well, looks like I'm going to be end up in prison. Well, see you at prison, everybody. Sorry about this.
Right, you, Bort. Come with me to the police station.
Oh, no.
Well, everybody, it looks like that Bort, however, has gone to prison. Well, at least Andy will be happy about this. I wonder why. Oh, I think I know. Because, Andy just couldn't handle Bort's behaviour anymore. Oh, well, that's a bit sad, really. Oh, well, I'm sure that everyone else in the family will probably get some sleep in the strange shed. See you at the shed, everybody.
All right, everybody. Well, I don't know about you, but Bort really has run away from home now. Yeah, since I did yell at him. And I did told you guys it was all my fault.
Oh, that's all right, Andy. Well, if Bort has to go to jail, well, at least you won't have any more trouble with him.
Yeah, I guess so, Barbara. Well, what are we going to do now?
Hey, guys!
Oh, who's that now?
I'm the director, Andy.
Oh, hello there. So, what's going on, Dietrich? Any news?
Well, I've got some good news. And some bad news for you.
What's the good news?
Well, the good news is, Andy, well, I think that, you won't have to put up with Bort's antics anymore.
Good.
And the bad news is, Andy, I'm afraid that whilst Bort is out for a walk, the police had to come and get Bort, and he is now arrested, and he's in prison.
What? Bort? In prison?
Oh no! Guys, I've got some bad news.
What's the bad news, Andy?
Well, I'm very sorry everyone, but Bort is ended up in prison and he's arrested and he's never getting out of Fred jail.
What? What? What?
Yeah, you heard right. Has Bear Bort is ended up in prison.
Andy, this is all my fault. Well, is it your fault, Dad?
Yes, son,
it is. Well, you know what, Dad? It's all our fault.
Oh, we shouldn't have created Bort like that.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, well, what are we going to do?
Oh, I don't know, Dad.
I want a hug.
Oh, I'm so bad.
Oh, son! Why, your big brother has sent up in jail!
Yes, I know, Dad!
Oh, my special little guy's in jail! Oh, Papa, this is my fault!
Yeah, it's all our fault, please!
Time for bed now.
Yes, Andy. Oh, when will we see our special little guy again?
I don't know. Oh, what are we going to do?
Oh, okay. I'm going to sleep anyway. I don't think I want to hear about Paul anymore.
Wah! I'll sleep on you, Andy.
Yeah, don't worry, at least. I'll join you.
Night night, Dad. Night night, Sean. Night night, Mum.
Night night, Ben.
Night night, Lise.
Night night, Benny.
Well, everybody, I don't know about you, but the Bearson family is now cried because Bort, however, has gone to jail. Oh, I feel sorry to hear that. Well, how are we doing for Bort in prison? Oh, hello, Maggie. I thought you were supposed to be in bed.
Maggie, to rescue Bob.
Really? How on earth are you going to rescue him?
Secret.
Secret? Oh, okay. Well, I won't tell if you won't.
Promise?
And I'll keep quiet because your family is asleep. So, just walk gently.
Okay.
Right.
That night, Bearson family, be back soon. Me rescue Bort. I can see you in prison to rescue Bort.
Same with me. Oh, well, it looks like Maggie is becoming an unlikely hero. Yuck. Welcome to the police station, Bort. Right, and I heard that you've just run away from home, and you shouldn't have done that. And as for your punishment, you are to go into jail for at least 20 years.
20 years?
And another year for being a bad boy. 21 years. Well, I hope you have fun in hell, Borty boy. Goodbye. Oh, and those ghosts of Pac-Man are going to God.
Oh no, I really am in jail big time.
Oh, shut up, Borty boy.
Oh. Wilfius, looks like I'm in jail. Only because I ran away from home. Well, I really am in jail for 21 years. Oh, this is all my fault. My dad was right all along. Call myself a good son like that. And I wish I'd never run away from home. I really want Maggie.
Excuse me, young man. I think, are you hungry?
No, go away.
Fine, well, have some banana in case you get hungry. There you are, boy, boy.
Oh, right, I was stuck with this yucky banana.
Well, if you don't like a banana, have an apple instead, boy, boy.
Oh, right. Now I've got nothing to do now. Well, I have not jigsaw puzzles, I hope.
Hey, Bort, in case you get bored, here's something for you to do, and it's a jigsaw book. Enjoy yourself, Borty boy.
Oh. Oh, no. Not jigsaw book. That's going to make my life a misery. Life in hell. Oh, that's it. I'm going to cry. Alright, yes. Well, if you're wondering why I'm still crying, well, basically, I've done all these puzzles. Well, I better see what it does it say. What's this? Be ready, Fred. By Friday the 30th, 8 p.m. What day is it today? Oh no, it's ready to party! Oh no, it's 9 o'clock! I reckon something is gonna happen! Well, I better get back in here. That's better, for now. Oh dear, I wonder if there's gonna be a killer in the house.
Huh? What on earth is that noise? Was that what any of them got? Excuse me.
Yeah?
Aren't you supposed to be guarding the place?
Sorry, Bob.
Yeah, sorry, Bob.
Yeah, they did.
Sorry. Right, let's go now.
No, I think Bort is still in the place. Oh, well, that's good. But I heard a strange noise. Did you blow up, Easy?
Hey, did you listen to me?
Oh!
Well, I think it could be someone else.
Oh, alright. Well, let's keep guard. And we'll make sure that there's no intruder trying to get Bort into a place.
Yeah, okay. Well, we'll keep an eye on Bort for a bit.
Yeah.
Well, I'm afraid I'm surrounded by packs, I guess. If I can be a window guy. Well, it's gonna take me now.
Huh? I can't see anybody. Huh? God, did you see anything that suspicious?
No, I haven't seen anything suspicious. Well, why?
Because I think I saw a little strange baby coming.
Oh, well, I didn't know there was a baby around here. But whatever it is, keep an eye.
Yeah, good idea.
Hey, who's that baby me? Please, Clay, is that you?
I did no such thing.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't. Oi. Stop arguing, you two. One more word from you two, or I shall tell the boss on you. Alright? One more word.
Yes. Sorry, Blinky.
Oh, sorry. That's alright.
Who's
helping
this time?
Maybe?
Is that you?
No, I think Blinky
did it. Oi! Don't you try to blame off me! Cut that out, you!
Hey! Oh, that was my... Hey! Oh yeah, I really got to you, right? So basically, I have got a face. Never mind, let me get back.
Oh, can I
show
my
face,
Blinky?
That's right.
Right, now let's focus on guarding Bort.
Little baby, what do you think you're doing here?
You're not supposed to be here. I mean, babies are too young to go to jail. You know that.
Is that Bort?
Right? Well, how about that? A baby actually speaks. Where? Well, I will not give back Bort, that he deserves to be in here for 21 years.
Help! Get up! John! Don't help me!
Oh, okay, yeah, we're coming.
Hey, Dave! Let me get away from Jeff! Give me your nature!
Oh, don't you won't.
Let me out of here!
Oh yeah, what? I'm gonna get you.
Surprise!
Hey, hang on a bit. Who on earth is that?
I think that must be Maggie from the Simpsons.
Oh, the Simpsons! Oh, I love the Simpsons. So, what's that got to do with that baby up there?
Obviously, I just saw Maggie climbing up through that up there.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah, that'll be fine. How are you getting on though, Blinky? Not very well. I may have lost her. Oh, when will you ever learn? Ow! You get up then. I've had enough for now. Alright. Well, I can't see her anywhere. You must be imagining things. Oi, I am not imagining things. Oh, yes, you are. Now come out here this instant. Very well.
Hey, Mr. Chair! Good work!
Oh, alright. I believe that she means you suck, like security guard. Oh dear, I have slobbered dead. Guard, I'm gonna let you take over now. Oh no, not our boss! Alright, now, alright then, ghosts, let's get Maggie!
Yeah, with pleasure.
Yeah, hey Kenny.
Yeah, I'm Kenny too. Me first, come guard.
Alright.
Hey, yeah.
Oh.
Guess. Oh no. Oh. In the bin.
Help! Help!
Ooh, is that Maggie's sister?
Ooh, my best friend. She's attacking the guard. Boy, I think she's gonna get all those ghosts and tuck it out. Or let it tuck in. Yeah, go Maggie.
You need to be up to the next
one,
boy.
Oh, thanks, Maggie.
Oi!
Hold on tight, Bort. Maggie to rescue you.
Woo! Looks like I'm free! I'm free! Oh, thank you, Maggie. You're my heroine.
Love you,
Bort. Yeah, I love you too, sweet Maggie. Can you take me back to the shed now? Because I've learned a lesson.
Okay. Maggie's carrying you.
Alright.
See you at the shed, everybody.
Yeah, see you at the shed. Oh, I'm so glad to be rescued by Maggie.
Well, viewers, looks like Maggie has rescued Bort Bearson in that one. I don't think anybody, I don't think I haven't done anything wrong this time. Well, it's a good thing I'm not going to be in jail.
What?
Maggie, what are you doing?
Bye-bye.
Oh, that is not fair. Why is it that I have to be in jail and not Borty Boy? All right. Sure, everybody.
Right, don't worry, guys. I'll get you out.
Thank you.
Oh, hello, everybody. Well, we're on to day two now. Yeah, since we've run away from home. You know, for what's caused our house to explode. Oh, Avery, wake up.
Good morning, Barbara.
Oh, good morning, Andy. Fancy some breakfast?
Yes, please, Barbara. Oh, I am a bit tired. Oh, and good morning, you two. Oh, good morning to you, Dad.
Oh, and good morning, my sweetie pie.
Good morning, Bunny. Well, I feel happy again. Well, what about you?
Yeah, I'm happy too. Yeah.
What?
Maggie, Mom!
I think she must have snuck off whilst we were all asleep. I think she said something about rescuing Bull.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh no, did Maggie go to prison too?
Uh-oh. Ah! Bort, Ben, that's enough shot.
Sorry.
I'm sorry, Ben. It's all right. I understand, but why you were yelling. Because Maggie has sort of snuck out while we're all asleep. Don't worry, we'll get her back.
Well, this is all my fault, Dad.
Oh, don't tell me it's your fault, son.
Yeah, it is, Dad. I mean, if I kept an eye on Maggie, none of this would have happened. When will she be back?
Don't you worry, son. I'm sure Maggie knows what she's doing. I mean, besides, Ben, she did rescue you before. Oh. All right, I suppose I better get up, then.
Are you all right, Dr. Ben?
I'm okay now, Mum. Sorry if I yelled. Yeah, I was a bit scared that Maggie just left. I mean, she is a little baby, after all.
Oh, it's okay, Ben. Yeah, I'm sure Maggie will be back. And I'm sure that she's got something planned.
Oh, yeah? Like what? Like bringing back a chicken kebab? Yeah, I certainly don't want chicken kebabs.
Don't you worry, Ben. I mean, it's not for you and Lisa to have. It's probably for me and your mum, obviously. Oh, and hopefully for Bort when he comes down to jail. Yeah, you know what Bort's like.
Yeah, I know, Dad. Yeah, I guess that we're all like, I guess we're all rotten bags. Except for Lisa, obviously. No offence to you.
Not Jacob, Benny. But I still love you, remember?
Yeah, of course, I still love you too. Guys, I don't know about you, but it's been a couple of days now since, Maud's just left, and I didn't know Maggie was gone.
Ben, I'm sure Maggie would be back, sure, Ben. I promise you that.
All right.
Okay, Bob. Maggie's here now. Maggie got it. Everything's all right. Here. Surprise!
Bort! Oh, my son!
Yay! My big bro!
Yay! My son! Oh, where's that, Maggie? How did you find him? What do you guys was keeping? I rescued Bort.
Oh, well, well done, Maggie. Oh, did you fight off those security guards?
Yes!
Well, pass it to me!
Okay! Here, Daddy!
Oh, thank you, Mike. Well, you're truly our heroine! Well, son. Right, come and have a hug on me, boy! Alright, Dad. Just coming. Ah! Alright everybody, but I'm back from prison. Oh, and don't ask who rescued me. It was Maggie.
Oh, I love you too, Maggie.
Thank you, Bob. And thank you so much for saying something to you.
That's alright. Yeah, because I think I have learned a lot. And I did think about it in prison. And yes, Dad, I thought about it.
What did you thought about there, Bort? You can tell me.
Well then, I'll sit on your lap. You see, Dad, whilst I was in prison, I've had a sudden thought that I've had done some very bad things with you all those years. And I know I often got you mad once in a while. And I know that I am a very bad son.
Yeah, I know, but, well, I am a bad father to you. And I'm sorry if I kept yelling at you.
Yeah, me too, Dad, and I yelled at you too. And I so sorry for that as well. So, will you forgive me now, Dad?
Of course I'll forgive you, son. Now, will you promise me one thing, son? No more pranks, especially silly ones.
Okay, Dad, I promise you I will never do any more pranks ever again. Not even when I call you a Dumbo.
Ah, good. Now, let's have a hug, eh?
Yeah, alright, Dad. Me.
Well, Bort, I'm so glad to have you back again. Yeah, I missed you, boy.
Yeah, I missed you too, Dad. And I'm sorry, and I'm also sorry if I had to run away from home. Yeah, I just couldn't take up your anger anymore. I had to run away, see?
Well, obviously, you shouldn't have run off like that, because you could have got arrested.
Yeah, but Dad, I have been arrested. I mean, I am a man after all, you know. I'm not a kid anymore.
I know you're not, son. But you're still a kid to me.
I mean, I thought your mum always said, you're a special little guy.
Oh, good.
Yep, and thank you, Maggie, for rescuing Ben then. I mean, good boy. You're our hero.
Thanks, Daddy.
Well, Bort, did you miss me whilst you were in prison?
Yes, Dad. Yeah, I do miss you. Yeah, because I kind of regret it a bit.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, but don't worry, Bort. We'll soon get back to our house as soon as our house has been repaired. Yeah, okay, Dad. Well, I better get you off then. Oh, and I'm also sorry if I caused our house to explode. That's okay, son. I understand now. Right, go be with Ben. Oh, and give your mum a hug too. Okay. Yeah, see you in a minute then, Dad. Yeah, see you in a minute, son. Alright, Barbara. Yeah, I'm ready. Alright, Mum. I'm ready to give you a hug.
Oh, okay, buddy. Oh, I missed you.
Yeah, I missed you too, Mum. Right, could you excuse me, Ben? Oh, alright. Come on, Maggie.
Oh, thanks, Mummy. Oh, I missed you.
Yeah, I missed you too, Bort. Oh, I love you.
Yeah, I love you too, Mum. And I'm sorry if I run off.
That's okay, Bort. I heard what your father said. Yeah, well, I think you might promise to father never to play prank on him again.
Yes, that's right. So, is it time for bed now?
Bort, we've already had our bedtime without you, because you were in prison. But don't worry, though, Bort. We switched to save you some breakfast.
Oh, good. Have we got some in the fridge, Dad? Yeah, of course, we got some food in the fridge. I will go and get it.
Okay, Andy.
Well, share a minute, everybody, when this day's over. All right, then, family. Well, aren't we all pleased that we're one big happy family again? Yeah, that's right, Dad. Yeah, I miss my big bro. Yeah, I miss him too, Batman.
Yeah, me too, Ben. What about you, Lisa? Me three. Me fair. I should have something, Bort.
What is it, Lise?
About the things I called you in all those times. I'll take it all back with Borty Boys.
That's okay. Yeah, I forgive you for that. Because, will you promise me, Lisa, never to call me Borty Boy again?
Yeah, of course I promise, Bort. Oh, it's good to have you back.
Yeah, thanks, Lise.
And I'm sorry if we all end up in a fight.
That's all right. In fact, we're all sorry. Yeah, I guess. All right, family. Well, I don't know about you, but I am a bit tired. I think we all say that we can go to bed now. All right. Yeah, I'm a bit tired too, Dad. Well, good night, Dad. Good night, son. Good night, Ben. Good night, Dad.
Good night, Ben, Lisa, darling.
Good night, Benny. Good night, Ben. Good night, Bort.
Yeah, good night, Maggie. Yeah.
Night, night, Maggie.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, Barbara.
Good night, Mum.
Good night, Mum. Good night, Barbara.
Night, night.
Let's go get some.
And so, the Bearson family is asleep at this time, all together again. I wonder how we're doing with the villains.
Well then, Blue and Yellow, I don't know about you, but I feel like kidnapping Lisa again. And then this time, it's payback time on Bort.
Oh yes, Billius.
Yeah, I agree with you, Billius.
Yeah, but tell you what, I heard that the Bearsons are asleep. Let's kidnap Lisa. And that's just to get her a revenge after what she did to me from Ben did to me before.
Yeah, I agree. Let's go.
Right, now we need to be staying very, very quiet so that we don't wake the Bearson family. Right, you two, I'm gonna put you two down. Right, let me do the kidnapping.
Okay.
Okay.
Right, off we go. Sounds like having a okay.
Oh, Penny, you're tickling me. Not even suddenly, I...
Right, I got her now. And now to kidnap her.
Ugh, I think we're all awake all of a sudden. Oh dear. Man? Yes, Dad? I'm very sorry to say, but I think I saw Billius sneaking into our shelter after she kidnapped your girlfriend.
What?
Oh no, he's gonna yell again. Oh dear. Excuse a minute, guys. Ah, that's better.
Oh, man. Why does my girlfriend have to get kidnapped? Oh, what did we ever do to sleep?
Oh, I don't know, Ben. I mean, I don't think I never normally saw her kidnapped before.
Wait
a minute.
I think I remember about Billius.
Let her go!
No! You're gonna have to grab me, and what are you gonna do with that?
Ah! Right! Get you now, Mr. Monster! Have to grab me!
What are you doing to me? Put me down!
Put me down, you fool! No! The thing that I can put down is so invisible!
Ha! Oh, it's all right, Daddy. I know who kidnapped my my wife. Who kidnapped Leisha, Ben? I think it must be Billius the Monster, the one I always defeat him.
What? Billius? Oh, that monster's nothing but trouble as well as Bort was.
No offense to you, boy. Now take it, Dad. What's going on, Ben? I'm afraid my wife is kidnapped, Bort. I feel sorry to hear that, Ben. Don't you worry, we'll all get Billius together. But it's just the fact we just have to make a new plan. Oh, alright. Well, I better go and join you anyway. Alright, everybody. Well, we'll make a plan. Shit a minute, everybody.
Right then, little lady. Right, now that I caught you now. And I'm sorry if I had to do this.
Well, that's not okay, Billius. Let me go!
No! You're not getting away by this thing, and I got two of my evil henchmen to help me. Blue and yellow. Blue and yellow, follow me!
Oh, okay, we're coming. Come on, yellow, let's go follow.
Okay.
Shit a minute, buddy.
Stay with me.
Nope. Sorry, Missy, but there is nobody to help you now. Not even if your stinky boyfriend or something.
Stinky boyfriend? Don't ever say that again.
Oh, well, I think you are. Now, where am I going to put you? For a start. Well, not in here, because that's too smelly. I think I know. I'll put you in there instead.
What are you doing, please? I don't want to be me.
No. You're gonna have to be put in here for the time being. Right, there you are. Now get in, Missy. And I'll have to tipple you.
Ah!
tell you not to tell you say sorry to me for trying to kill me.
Oi, stinky Billiban.
Stinky Billiban? Don't ever call me that again.
Well, I think you are, and I think your evil henchman is nothing but shovel. And I think your butt is smells like Bob the Builder's butt.
Bob the Builder's butt? Bob the Builder's butt? How dare you? Right, I'm going to give it a shake. No, I know you're going to say sorry. Say it, Misty. Nope. You know what? I'm not going to leave now. You out of here. Because you'll never escape. Goodbye, Lisa Sim Doo. Lisa Sim Poo.
Oh!
All right then, family. Now, don't worry about Lisa. Now, we just need a new plan to defeat evil Billius once and for all. Yeah, I agree with you, Dad. Yeah, I'm glad you're joining on my side. Yeah, I know, Ben. Yeah, because I heard you defeated Billius before. Yes, and I want to defeat him again. Yeah, because Billius is one of the worst monsters that was created by none other than Dr. George. Oh, really? Yes. Yeah, that's why exactly we need a new plan. And the only plan is that we're all going to end up fighting against Billius and his two henchmen. Yeah, because it makes me want to get at Billius. Oh, and Maggie can do the henchmen, can't you, Maggie?
Yeah, Maggie can.
Yeah. Yeah, she can, Dad. Oh, and I think all three of you will have to fight off the henchmen whilst I rescue Lisa. Oh, yeah, I forgot about the rescue bit. Yeah, you can also rescue Lisa as well, Ben. And I'm sure she'll be delighted to be rescued. Yeah, just like in Donkey Kong. Yep. Yeah, come on, family. Let's go and defeat Billius!
Yay! Fighting! With me saving Lisa. Oh yeah, your big sister Maggie.
Okay, Dad.
Yay! Fighting!
Yeah, fighting! We're coming, Auntie.
Right, follow me, everybody! Share a minute, everybody.
Let's see if we fight. Come on, Bort. You can be with me.
Alright, Mom. Right, come on, Maggie. Let's fight Billius together.
Okay, Dad.
Oh, see you outside, everybody.
Right then, Barbara. Ready to fight on Billius?
Yeah, ready.
Right, okay.
Charge!
Right, now that I've got Lisa trapped, there's no one to rescue her.
Oh, yes, there is. Stinky.
Huh?
And what are you doing to my girl?
Your girl? Your girl? What? Do you mean your stinky wife?
Stinky wife? Stinky? How dare you, Billius? Well, we meet again.
Not today, Big Ben. Prepare to fight.
Yeah, bring it on, Tubby.
Tubby? No one ever calls me Tubby.
Well, I think you are. And your evil henchmen are Blue and that Blue Dozy Bozos. Stinky Bozos? Stinky Bozos? How dare you? Yeah, I agree. How dare you? We're all going to have a fight with you, aren't we, Billius?
Yeah, of course we are. And don't worry about Lisa. I put her in there.
Ah, good job.
Yeah, thank you. That's what being a villain is all about.
Yeah. Well, you let her go.
No, not until you fight with me. And what are you doing with those sausage fingers?
Sausage fingers? How dare you? They are not sausage fingers. Right, let's fight.
Yeah, let's do it now.
But first...
Oh, my groin, oh, my groin.
Oh. Right, let's fight.
Yeah, bring it on.
Ow, 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 ow,
You think you could defeat me easily? Not this time!
Oh, I thought you'd just been dead for a minute.
Right, blue and yellow, get him!
With pleasure.
Yeah, with pleasure, man. Okay, we're going to defeat you, but be first, blue.
Okay.
Oi!
Oh!
Whoa! What is that? Oh, it's Danny coming to see me. Go, Danny, beat up the beat up sinners.
I will, m'lady.
Oi!
Oh, hi, Bob.
Get off!
Now it's your turn, Bozo.
Oi! Don't you call me. Oi, oi, oi!
Oh! Oh, hello.
Oi, oi, get off here, Seth. Oi, get off me. Ah, oh. Blue!
Sorry.
Oh! Call yourself a henchman. If you two can't do anything right, let me do it.
Be right here. But besides, I've had enough of being French henchmen anyway. Come on, Yellow, let's get out of here.
Yeah, alright. Yeah, I agree, Blue. You know, I don't want to be on your side anymore.
Ow!
Finish her yourself. I've had enough of this.
Yeah, won't we, Blue?
Yeah,
I agree. But what do we do now?
Well, I suggest we should get out of here before the police comes and arrests us.
Yeah, good idea. Good. See you soon, everybody.
See you soon.
Ugh. Well, it looks like it's up to me now. Don't. Right then, Stan. It's you and me this time. And no payback.
Oh, yes, there is. We got one special person who always growls when airport annoys her.
Oh, yeah. What? Is it Maggie Simpoke?
Maggie Simpoke? Don't ever say that again.
Oh yeah? How about Lisa Simpoke?
Oh yeah? Maggie, come here, girl.
Yes?
I'm afraid that Billius and Courtney is Maggie Simpoke. Get him!
Yes, sir.
Oh no, what's he gonna do to me?
Well, she's gonna attack you, that's why.
Oh, poo!
Oh,
oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, yeah, that's what you get, Billius. You're nothing but a big pair of Bob the Builder's bottom.
Oi!
Uh-oh, I better get out of here.
Oh, where up is that Betty Boop go?
Let's see that picture.
Oh, with pleasure. Right, don't you worry, Lisa, honey. I'm here to free you. Hold on. Oh. Dad, can you help me?
Sure thing, that son. Right, let me just lift that basket up. Right, here we go. They don't call me the strong man for nothing. There you go, Bet. Thanks, Dad.
Well, it's okay, Lisa. You're free.
Oh, Benny, thank you so much for rescuing me. Oh, you deserve a great big kiss.
Oh, gosh.
Me.
Ooh, sounds like Ben Person. Has fallen in love with her. Yeah, you always fell in love with her, don't you?
Yeah, but, oh, and I had to defeat Billius.
Oh, well, that's good to hear. I wonder how he's getting on, speaking of which. Hey! What happened to that flower pot that I just put on her? Oh, it must have been that bloody boot or something.
Oi! Right, hang on there, sweet. Oh, and Maggie will look after you.
Oh, all right, Benny. Be careful. He's vicious.
Oh, don't you worry. I will handle this.
And how dare you call me Betty Boop?
Well, how dare you try to free her? You know I wanted to kill her.
Well, I certainly don't want you to kill her. Do you know what? I'm going to have a fight with you again. And this time, my family is going to fight on you.
Oh, no. Not your bloody family. Your family is nothing but trouble.
Family, get Billius.
With pleasure, son.
Yeah, with pleasure, son. Come on, Bort. What do you say? We go and fight Bat Monster.
Yay!
Oh, I always wanted to fight.
Right, you first, boy. All right.
And I'll join you.
And I'm going to join
you. Oh, help! Help! I've been attacked by my son, Bat! Off the bat!
No,
sorry, we're not helping you anymore. Remember, you said you told us to go away.
Yeah, you sure did. Didn't he, Yellow?
Yep, he sure did. Right, let's get out of here. Problem.
Well, see you later, sucker.
I come back here! Alright, get off me, Bearson family! Well then, why do you and your family try to defeat me?
Because I think you are a great big jumbo for stinky
elephant. I jumbo! The elephant!
You better not do something to my son.
Oh, yes, I will. When you least expect it. And take this sucker.
Ow!
Right, and now to hurt you.
No, please. No!
Yes! I finally defeated Ben for good. Yes, it's Series 6. Whoopity doo, whoopity doo, whoopity doo, whoopity doo!
Billius, get off! Ow!
You stupid monster! How could you defeat our hero? Well, because it was payback for all the mean things he did to me.
Oh, yeah, and I expect that a certain police officer is coming to arrest you.
Oh, yeah? And what is he going to do about that? What? Is that the siren? Oh no!
Hello, 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 hello. What's going on here then?
Oh, who's that? Ah! Oh, hello there, officer. Oh, hello, Andy. Oh, I thought I recognised you. You're the father of Bort. Yeah, that's right. Well, I think the police would like to apologise for arresting your son by mistake. Well, that's okay. Well, obviously, it's Billius over here that needs some arresting, because he just hurt my son! What? Is that true, young man?
No, of course it must not be. It was those two who did.
Don't you try to blame them on your henchmen. I heard what was going on. Fudge has already told me. Didn't you, Fudge? Yeah, I sure did. Don't worry, Andy. I've already explained. I think the officer's already explained to me about what happened. All right, then, officer, arrest him, please. Oh, with pleasure, Fudge. And I'm arresting him too, And I'm arresting him too, Andy. Oh, good. Now, take him away. With pleasure, Andy. Right, you, Phil, lie down on your belly. Ow! Right, you are now handcuffed, so you're going to have to come with me to the police station so we can put you and your henchmen to jail.
Hey, you can't do that to me. That's because I just want to get revenge on you. Oh, curse you, Betty Boop. Curse you.
Yeah, good friends to you, Billius. You're not very lucky because we defeated you at last. And no one messes with my son. Not even Bort or Ben.
Are you all right, Leash?
No, Andy. I just saw my friend has been injured.
Injured? Oh, what? I better go and help him! Ow! Oh. Well, I guess I'm injured now.
Oh, I'm not going to join you, Andy. Maggie, you want to come with me? Come on. Come on, then. See you later, everybody.
Are you okay, Sean? Ben?
Ben? Ben? Come here, mate, buddy. Ben? Ben? Oh, no. My son's dead.
Bad news, girls. Ben is dead.
What? Oh, no. Looks like my Benny died. Oh, Ben. How could Phineas have hurt you like this? I can't sleep, bud. No, at least you don't. At least now, you're in peace. You're gone. No, I thought I said any way to bring you back.
Oh dear.
Like, I agree. Our bed is gone. I can't.
Well, you two. Well,
at least now he's in peace. My son is gone. It was only ever a way to bring back my son to be alive again. Oh, and Lisa, there's nothing we can do. He's gone. I know, Andy. Well, Benny, I guess I'm not very sad to see you. Maggie, where are you going?
Where's she going to, Dodgers?
Well, I believe she's going to get something. Something that might revive Ben again.
Oh.
Oh, dear. Yeah, well, I hope that works. Oh, my son.
I'll sort that out for you.
Let's have a look. Well, cinema feels fine. All right, Maggie, right, I've found the right one, and it's Pepsi Max. I'm sure Ben will probably have a sniff of it.
Okay. Come with Maggie, please.
Oh, what have we got there, Maggie? Oh, and I see that's an empty can.
Hey, why don't you just put it under Ben's nose?
Okay. But then...
What's that smell? Was that a sudden drink?
Penny?
Hang on, I've got to recognise that smell. It's Pepsi Max! Mmm, I love that drink!
Oh, Penny!
Lisa!
Oh, Penny! I would have died!
Oh, it's alright, Lisa, honey. Oh, it's okay. I'm alive now. Alright, Lisa, you can just get off a bit once I try to break the mag.
Love you, Penny. I love you.
Yeah, I love you too, sweet. Yay! Well, I'm so glad that my son's alive. Alright, Lisa, I'm just going to hug Ben for a minute. Yeah, excuse me.
Alright, Andy.
Oh, Sean! Yes! Yes! Oh, Ben. I missed you, Sean.
Yeah, I missed you too, Dad.
Yeah, I'm sorry about this. That's okay, but I'm glad you're okay. That's the main thing. And thank you, Mandy. You saved the day.
Thank you, Auntie Bunchy.
You're welcome. All right, then, Ben. Well, I'm going to leave you for a bit. See you in a minute, buddy. Oh, yeah, and also to tell the family about the good news.
Well, Maggie, I can't believe you survived me! Oh, well done! Well done, you little girl!
Yeah,
you're welcome, Dad. Yippee! Oh, I'm so lucky you're sitting in the moon!
Alright, Maggie, well, I better put you down.
Ooh, sounds like Maggie's blushing!
Better get back to the family. See ya.
Well, Lisa, aren't you pleased that I am alive?
Yeah, of course I'm proud of Penny. Oh, here we sit on a perch.
Yeah, good idea. Come on then, let's go. See you at the bench, everybody.
See you at the bench.
Alright then, family. Right, I've got some good news for everybody. The good news is that Ben Bearson is still alive.
Yay!
Oh, well, Benny, oh, was he brave yourself?
Yeah, of course I was, Mum. Yeah, because Maggie her here had revived me.
Haven't you, my magpie?
Yeah.
See? She did help.
Oh, well done, Maggie. You saved the day.
Yeah, well done, Maggie. You saved us all. And in fact, I could give you a lovely kiss.
Thank you, Maggie, you're the best.
Oh, but I'm so pleased that my sister Maggie has to give it my best. Thanks, Maggie.
Yeah, but hug that.
Well, the important thing is that Billius the Monster is now arrested and ends up in jail.
Yay!
Yay!
Whoopee! Well, except the fact that I got hurt. No, you worry, son. You're okay. And same to you, Lisa. Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm okay now, Andy. Now that Benny rescued me.
Ah, good. Well then, Ben, I'm so proud of you, son. And I give you a salute for this.
Oh, thanks, Dad. I love you, Dad.
Hey, I love you too, son. Yeah, and I'm glad that you're very sensible. Bort, yes? About the mean things I said about you, I take it all back.
Good. So do I on pranks.
So, shall we all go home now, Dad? Yeah, good idea, Sean. Let's go. Ben, are you going to come too?
No thanks, Dad. I think I'll stay outside. And besides, I'm going to be sitting on this bench with the little lady I love. Oh, and I will be back in the house for at least half an hour.
Okay, Sean, but be back in the house before it gets dark, okay?
Okay, Dad.
Alright, come on, Maggie. Do you want to come with me?
Yeah, please.
Alright, come on, Maggie. Let's take you home. Give him a kiss.
Bye-bye, Ben.
Yeah, bye, Maggie.
Yeah, bye, Sean. Oh, and goodbye, everybody. See you soon. Bye!
Yeah,
Come on, Bort, you can come too.
All right. Well, see you later, everybody, and see you next time.
Bort!
All right, Dad, I'm going. This time.
Oh, and bye-bye me, Barbara, and see you later, son.
Yeah, see you later, Mom, and I will be back in the house in half an hour.
We're off, Anthony. Oh, isn't it great to be outside?
Yeah, I agree with you, little lady. I mean, besides, don't go breaking my heart.
I couldn't if I would. Oh, Penny, I love you.
I love you too, sweetie. Right, let's kiss each other.
Okay.
Oh, look at that. They are so adorable together. Yeah, even for this movie.
So, Lisa, how was it?
It's nice.
Oh, does that mean you like it?
Yes.
Oh, Lisa. Well, see that it's nearly dark soon.
Fancy a dance by the moonlight?
Yes, please, Penny.
Okay, come on then. Let's go and dance somewhere.
Okay, Penny.
Well, see you in a minute, everybody.
Well, I guess that they're going to dance by the moonlight. Yeah, see, it is getting a bit dark anyway. Yeah, I suppose we'll just finish this off anyway. And then we'll get to the villains when they're in jail, as promised.
Right then, Lisa, my darling. Ready to dance by the moonlight?
Yes, please, Benny.
Okay, go on then. Let's dance. Oh, cue music, please, maestro. Any music, I'm not fussy.
Right, off we go.
Lady, and I'm so glad to be alive. And so, that's probably the end of the movie.
Excuse me, young man, that's not the end of the movie yet, you know.
Oh, sorry. What I was meant to say, is that I got a question on everyone's mind and lips. What about the villains? And I wonder how they're getting on in jail. Probably a doubtful time, no doubt. Well, I'd better leave Ben and Lisa to it, to get on with their dancing. Well, enjoy dancing, you two. We will.
We will. Penny.
Lisa. How I adore you. Well, see you soon, everybody.
Mm-hmm.
This is how we're doing with the villains. See you later.
Well, everybody, I don't know about you, but I guess I'm in jail now for trying to kill Ben as revenge. What do you think, Hedgeman?
Well, yes. Well, only because I just didn't want to get involved in it anymore. So shut the hell up, Billius.
Yeah. I agree, because you're nothing but trouble, you are.
Oh yeah? Well, if you two hadn't been on my side, I wouldn't have defeated Ben in the first place. Well, I think we're all fools.
Well, I think you're the biggest fool around here.
Shut up, Blue.
Oi, don't you tell me to shut up.
Yeah, don't you tell him to shut up like that, you stupid old tart.
Oi, I am not a big old tart. Well, I don't know what we're going to do now, fellas. But whatever it is, we'll have to be in jail for at least 100 years.
Oh, no. I am not staying here with this evil yellow monster by the time he grows a moustache. I am out of here.
Oi, get back in jail, you.
Oh, darn it.
Yeah, sorry, Blue, but there's no escape this time. Yeah, because I think we've got four blue, colourful ghosts to come and watch over us.
Oh, no.
it seems like that we are not the only ones that are ghosts. I think the Pac-Man ghost and us have got something in common.
Well, it looks like I'm stuck now. Well, Benny Boop, go and have fun with that stinky simp poop that you have. Go ahead and have fun without me. See if I care.
Oh, cheer up, Billius. You know what they say.
Oh, what do they say, Mr. Bear? I am not interested.
Yeah, we are not interested at all.
Yeah, neither do we.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you sort their prayers for bears. But when you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble. Give a whistle, and this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the bright side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing in which you should all face. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chump, just push your lips and whistle, and that's the thing. And always look on the bright side of life.
Oh, shut up, Mr. Bear.
Always look on the light side of life. Don't you tell me to shut up, because life is quite absurd, and that's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow to the Bearsons. Forget about your sin, give the audience a grin. Let Bort Bearson, it's your last shot, anywho. So always look on the bright side of bears. Yeah! Just before Bearsons are after me. That's the piece of when you look at it. Life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show. Keep on laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And always look on the bright side of life. Come on, Billius, do it in!
I always look on the bright side of life.
Very good, Billius. Come on, Billius, a cheer up a bit. Always look on the bright side of life. Right, your turn, you two.
Okay,
keep
up. Always look on the bright side of life.
Oh, very good, Yellow. Worst thing happened to see, you know. Always look on the bright side of life. Very good, Blue. Thank you. Always look on the bright side of life. Right, over to the Simpsons, baby!
Always look on the bright side of life.
Well, I don't know about you, everybody. That's the end of one franchise for the Bearsons. Now, if you haven't seen the Bearsons yet, go and check it out on YouTube. Yeah, because the Bearsons, I heard, it was getting popular because I was acting out as Grandpa Bearson. And boy, we always look on the bright side. And I'm pretty sure Ben and Lisa will make a very great couple. Yeah, and I'm pretty sure they'll have fun together. Oh yeah, and look out for the other programs too. Goodbye. Alright then, you three. Well, did you all enjoy seeing into that?
Well, I feel a bit happy now. Yeah, thanks to you, Mr. Bear. And how on earth did you get to be in here?
Well, but because of the Bearsons was getting popular in those days, I thought I might as well just join in.
Oh, good for you, Mr. Bear.
Yeah. Mr. Bear? Yes, Blue? I just don't know what happened to the other security guard. Well, whatever it is it okay if me and Yellow can go? I mean, we did run away from Billius. I mean, we don't feel it anymore, you know. Oh, are you sure? Yes. Well, I'll ask the new boss. Excuse me, is it okay if we release these two villains? Well, I don't know, Adder. Well,
seeing as that these two haven't done anything more, well, although they did try to attack Bern for once, well, let's just say they'll stay in there for one more day, and then it's time for them to get out. Very well. Well, at least you get to stay in there for one more day, and then it's time for you to go home. Thank you, Mr. Bear.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Bear.
Good. Right, and I shall be in guard. Well, see you a bit first when it's the next day.
Same with both of us.
One day later.
Okay then, you two. Right, day's up now, so you two might as well just get out of a jail. Ah, thank you, Mr. Bear.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Right, and I'll lift up that cushion. Right, out you go now. Ah, thank you.
Oh, I want to be here. I want to be free. Oi, get back in jail, Billius.
Ah. Well, you two. Well, I'm glad that you two have changed your behaviour now. So we decided to let you leave early. Well done. Aw, thank you, Mr. Bear.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Bear. Oh, and I'm sorry if we keep calling you that. Do you mind if we call you Mr. Bear?
No, I certainly don't mind at all. I mean, after all, I am no hair bear.
Oh, well, nice to meet you, Miss No Hair Bear.
Yeah, okay, well, I'll let you get out now. Thank you, No Hair Bear. Well, come on, I think we better leave Billius now. Yeah, I don't think it's worth being with him anyway.
Ah, good idea.
Oh, well then, Billius, well, it looks like we're both out now, so you stink, and I'm going to wiggle my bum. Well, see you later. Billius the bottom booster.
Billius the bottom. Oh, I'll get you two villains. Get you.
Well, you never will, because I think that you are staying in there for 100 years.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, bye-bye, everybody.
Yeah, bye-bye, everybody.
Well, and as for you, Billius, you're staying in jail for at least 100 years. Goodbye, Bill the Monster.
Oh, why me? Why now? Now I'm unhappy again.
Well, do you want me to see you always on the look of the bright side life again?
No.
Okay, quiet. Besides, I've had enough.
All right. Well, everybody, now, if you're wondering why I'm here at the end, well, it's just because I heard that my old friend George had created the Bearsons Movie.
Oh, I remember now, because I used to be part in George and Arthur the Movie.
And now we got a second one. Ah, good job, Mr. Foxton.
Ah, thank you, Derby, and well done for being a guard. Right, you can go home now, and I'll take care of Billius for you.
Thank you. Well, bye-bye, everybody. See you soon. Bye-bye.
And bye-bye from George the Creator.
All right, everybody. Now, before we finish this movie, here's one last shot. And this is only coming from Lisa Simpson, who will be singing Come a Long Way. Yep, because us Bearsons have come a very long way since the Shores. So, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Lisa Simpson. Take it away.
Okay, I think I'm coming. Hello, everybody! I'm here to sing a special song that I'd like to dedicate this song about my penny. Keep the music, Maestro!
Oh, with pleasure, Missy. And here we go!
It was cold at night when you came into my troublesome life, and it seemed as though everything's gonna be alright for the moment. Since then, here and there, my life's become like a roller coaster ride. Up and down, round and round.
always fighting, y'all. Yeah, yeah. Constant struggle. Meaningless fights. Irritation.
But then soon we overcame them all. One by one, side by side, we gave each other love that's real and everlasting. Warm, real love. We come a long way, you and me together. Even though we have fights, we're still alive.
Rock together, want us to stop? Yes, forever. It's only rain, rolling this maintains forever. Seasons change, you know you can't change the weather. One by one, side by side, we stand forever in your arms. Together with hands, life's like a roller coaster ride. A second you hide, you give it a try, you get down and you cry.
It was cold that night when you came to my troublesome.
Thank you, Lisa. You know what? You're my best lady ever.
And you are my best man.
That's good. Yeah. Do you know something? You and I have come a long way since we first met, and it's a good thing you and I were married back in Series 5.
Yeah, I guess. Oh, and I wonder how Billius is doing.
I expect that he's spending his time 100 years in prison.
Yeah, at least he won't get it this time.
Of course not.
And you know, Benny, I think I can do a special something.
Ooh, a special something? Ooh, what is it?
Well, I believe it'll be this. The goodnight kiss.
Oh, the goodnight... pardon?
Well, I've had a fun time with you during the show, and it's yours. Here's my goodnight kiss, Benny Boo.
Oh, madame. Oh. Well, do you know what, Lisa?
What is it, Benny?
This is the happiest day of my life!
Everyone, let's get started. It's second hand like a brass band. Could be old, it could be new. It's good for me and it's good for you. Oh. rider care. British Heart Foundation, Oxfam, Shelter, Bernardus, Marie Curie,
Thank you, Nerva, for giving us the laughs and have fun in heaven for infinity and beyond. Toy Story reverence, anyone? And anyways, let's hand over to Andy Bearson to do his dedications. Alright, everybody. Now, before we end this movie, here are five dedications. First one is, I dedicate this movie to George Widow Hairbear, who is celebrating 5 years of. So, happy 5th anniversary, you two, and I hope you've had lots of fun as me and my family have. Oh, and the second dedication would be from Louis Walden, who loves charity shops. Yeah, because you and I, Louis, have come a long way since we started on GBC Playdate. So, yeah, that's dedication to you, mate. Oh, and I would like to thank you for helping George get a Lisa, a Simpson, and Maggie plush toys. Without those two, Benny would never be without her all the time. So thank you, Louis. And here's dedication number three. Number three is that I would also like to dedicate to Servant Bird and of course, George's special friend, Vintage Lover, a.k.a. Poppy, who loves vintage things. Well, it's on you too. Yeah, hello there. And here's number four. Number four is that I would like to dedicate this film to George's father, Andrew. Because George's father's name was Andrew, because George, however, has been inspired is because of me. Because I am Andy, as most of your biker friends call you that. So that's why I am Andy Bearson, and I do sound like you. Very much. And finally, fifth and final dedication is that I may not be here now, but don't worry, the Bearsons will live on. Okay, well, that's pretty much all the dedications there is now. And now that I'm finished, alright, Mr. Cameron, could you switch off the camera now?
Why?
Just do it.
Well, how about no?
Alright then, Mr. Cameron. Right, that's enough now.
Oi!